Sakuigar Bones here, and I am back with my Sith Inquisitor. Gonna be going to Korriban today to get my my new apprentice. So first off, we got some convos here. Let's start off with the Shara.
I've been thinking more about what Master Simon said, and I think he was wrong.
That makes two of us.
He believed we were wrong and that you were leading me astray, but he did nothing.
Of course he didn't. He was weak. He knew he couldn't do anything.
That's exactly what I mean. The Jedi's refusal to do what's necessary to fight, it makes them weak. The Jedi will never beat the Empire if they won't take the offensive. And they'll never win peace either if the Empire can't respect them. Peace is a noble goal, but it's not a means to an end.
So you're saying peace is a lie?
When it comes to making real change? Yes. I guess I am. A war rages and Master Simon meditates in his clearing. Personal peace is one thing, but apathy, inaction, these things are unacceptable.
Well, hey, we might just make a Sith out of you yet, Ashara.
I have a question for you, but you must promise not to mock me.
I can make no such promise.
I've never actually played Sabacc, or Pazak, or any of those kinds of games. I was wondering if you'd teach me.
You've never played Sabacc? Unbelievable.
I knew you'd mock me. I'm sorry I asked.
Couldn't help it. Alright, good old Talos.
My lord, I think we make an excellent team. Truly, destiny herself has conspired to bring us together.
I'm sorry, Talos. I like you, but I just don't think of you that way.
Oh, no. No, that's not. I didn't mean it that way, of course. I've learned so much at your side. My archaeologist's instincts are honed to a razor's edge, or a pick's point, as the case may be.
And then last but not least, Andronikos.
I've got him. Reich, the SIS agent who betrayed me. He's a dead man. My old girl Casey intercepted an encrypted message. He's moving on Trandoshia, of all places, as we speak. I've got to fly or I'll lose him.
It's not as if I can stop you.
This is the last bit of business tying me to my Republic days. This is the last time I'll run, I promise. Reich's dead. Was dead before I got to him. Lucky jerk. Turns out I wasn't the only enemy he made selling secrets. Imperial intelligence sniper got him. Guess he was playing both sides.
I'm sorry you missed your chance at revenge.
I only wish I could have got an explanation. But I guess he was just rotten all around. I'm done running off. You and Casey are the only friends I got. And, well, you're the only one with a ship.
Does this mean you're done, being a bloodthirsty killer?
Nah, but maybe I'm done going after revenge for a bit, huh?
Alrighty then. Yeah, that's gotta be a bit disappointing. Finally about to get your revenge and then someone else takes it. Going back home to Korriban. Gonna see our good old friend Harkin once again. Can't get enough of the guy. Here we go.
My lord, you are just in time. The acolytes should be returning shortly.
There's something vaguely unsettling about Boneface. He's hardly said a word, but he's got a determined glint in his eye. Reminds me of you.
Mogoto ni ompi bedwana, nibobo, choba uma.
Ah, there you are. My lord, it looks as if we were both wrong. May I present to you your apprentice? Ahem.
Maybe I wasn't so wrong after all.
Ah, Boneface. So you're not dead, then?
Zalek.
Hmm?
My name is Zalek. Your carving, my lord.
Slave scum! Did you not listen to the rules of this academy? You do not murder another acolyte, and in the presence of witnesses! I'm sorry, my lord. It seems I've failed to teach this miserable dog a single lesson. I will let you know when a new shipment of slaves arrives.
It's all right, Harkon. I like his style.
He murdered an acolyte in the academy walls, in the presence of an overseer and a lord of the Sith. To top it off, he's a slave! Sith tradition demands he be executed.
Do not make me remind you the cost of disobedience.
No, my lord. But Thanaton will hear of this.
My lord.
I think you'll fit in well with my crew.
I think I missed it. Isn't there a way where you can use a mind trick on Harkon and have him give Zalek his lightsaber? I wanted to do that. I should have gone back. Dang it. Because I remember doing that last time, but maybe I'm remembering it wrong. I'm pretty sure that happened. Dang, that's disappointing. Yeah, I think I was supposed to pick the middle option, and then it would have given me the second option to do it. Dang, that's disappointing. I wish I could just quit or abandon it and get the quest back for it or replay it, but I can't. I should have just restarted the convo.
My lord, Moff Valion Pyron, I am satisfied to report that the silencer is complete. But we have limited time to test it before Thanaton intervenes. The prototype is mounted aboard the Imperial Starship Doombringer. Meet me there. I have already invited the Moffs I feel would be most favorable to your cause. It falls to you to do the persuading.
Good work, Moff Pyron. I will meet you there.
Excellent. I'll have you know Imperial Engineering has outdone themselves. I shall see you aboard the Doombringer.
Doombringer, that's a good name. And there's Zalek. I'll probably take him with me. You know, it's actually kind of refreshing being on an Imperial warship and no one's attacking you. Because it doesn't matter if it's Republic or Empire, every time you go on an Imperial warship, the crew's trying to kill you. Nice change of pace there. Refreshing.
Ah, there she is. This, my fellows, is the future of the Sith Order, who will lead the Empire into a new moment.
What is a no-name Sith Lord going to do against a Dark Council member? Thanaton will have our heads.
Thanaton grows more insufferable every day. Our ancient and mystical Sith traditions will win wars, he says. Not generals with training.
Don't worry. The next time I meet Thanaton, he will die.
Then talk to me after he's dead. I won't stick my head out until I know it won't get cut off.
Enough, Dolus. We are not here to listen to you bicker. We're here today to demonstrate a new weapon, codename Silencer. You boys may have heard of it.
What are you drinking, Pyron? Thanaton killed the Silencer project.
Soon you will see an entire Republic fleet disappear, thanks to the Silencer and the tireless efforts of the Empire's champion. My lord?
Moths, generals. Today you will see who holds the real power in the Sith Empire. Not the Dark Council, not Thanaton, me. When I finish my ascent, all will bow or face my might.
Isaac, prepare the Silencer to fire.
Moff Pyron, my lord, we're receiving an Imperial signal.
Doombringer. Darth Achelon of the Carnage requests your aid in fighting the Republic fleet. Repeat, the Carnage needs your aid.
Who is this Darth Achelon?
Darth Achelon is one of Thanaton's cronies. Let him get blasted.
You would knowingly destroy an Imperial vessel. You propose treason, Graham.
The fleet will tear him to shreds anyhow. If we go in there, that'll be two Imperial vessels destroyed. My lord?
If Achelon wants help, he'll get it. Not that it'll do him any good. Use the weapon.
Yes, my lord.
Amazing. I can't believe my eyes.
I agree. You've made quite the impression, my lord. Consider us interested in an alliance of sorts.
Moff Pyron, see that each of these men gets a silencer for his capital ship. I expect this will be a quite fruitful relationship.
Of course, my lord. Come, gentlemen. We have much to discuss.
Ooh, look at the Carnage. I assume there's some kind of a counter to the silencer. Otherwise, that'd be freaking OP if every capital ship has one. Or not everyone, but, you know, a few of them.
You have remarkable energy. Who knew the Silencer project could be such a resounding success? But capital ships are not trivial resources.
If you can't take the loss of a single ally...
That has nothing to do with it. This ends now. I declare a Kagath, a contest of mutual annihilation, pitting power base against power base. Whoever sheds the most blood wins. To the victor, eternal glory. To the loser, death and shame.
May the best Sith win.
May the best Sith win. Corellia is the arena. The Kagath begins when you land. Forfeit and be disgraced. Hounded to the ends of the galaxy by every Sith in the Empire.
My lord, that was an open channel. Thanaton broadcast the whole thing. He wants everyone watching the Kagath as it unfolds. He is well entrenched on Corellia, but the Empire's fighting a significant battle there. The chaos could be an advantage. With your permission, I'll transfer to Corellia so that the fleet can provide you support.
That sounds more than sufficient.
Yes, my lord. I will try to learn of any weaknesses in Thanaton's power base.
Goodness gracious. The Empire's going to Corellia to fight a war, but instead, we're just going to spend it the whole time killing each other instead. That is no wonder why the Empire loses all the time. The Sith Empire, anyways. Well, actually, since this is going to be a shorter episode, I'm going to go ahead and do the convos here right now. So let's start with Zalik.
Lord, I look forward to training with you.
If you pull anything on my watch, like you did against Harkon, I will shoot you out an airlock.
Yes, Lord.
I don't suppose Harkon has bothered to teach you anything useful, like the Sith Code?
Kill or be killed.
I am going to have to teach you everything. Hmm? All right, then. Repeat after me. Peace is a lie.
The Force shall free me.
You may not talk much, but at least you're not stupid.
Command me, and I will strike, my lord.
Well, you'll be a better Sith than Ashara, I think, so there's some competition there. So you got one for Andronikos and the other two here.
My lord, I have incredible news. A group of Jedi have split from the Jedi Order. This is the perfect opportunity for us to win allies.
Divide and conquer. I like it.
Yes, I guess you could put it that way. Now, these guys aren't like Master Simon, but I think that actually gives us a chance. They're hardliners, very anti-Sith, but their argument with the Jedi is over methods, not aims. Unlike Master Simon, they say they are willing to do whatever is necessary.
Then they're our kind of Jedi.
The main Jedi Council will never deal with a Sith unless he turns to the light. A splinter group is exactly what we need. I'm going to meet with them. I promise I won't be long. My lord, thank you. We have new allies in the Rogue Jedi, but I couldn't have done it without your training.
What did they say?
They were skeptical at first. Like Master Simon, they would not accept me as a Jedi. But this time I knew what to say. You helped me understand. Sith and Jedi is an arbitrary divide. I don't know what I am, and I don't care. I told them the Jedi need to be willing to do whatever it takes, even ally with a Sith, to bring peace to the galaxy.
And they didn't laugh you out of the room?
There were some who remained skeptical. Their leader, Master Quintus, said that he would be unwise to turn his back on such conviction and determination. Thank you for letting me meet with them, my lord.
Just means more people for my Sith Inquisitor to manipulate later, I guess. You know, I'm actually pretty low level for Corellia, so I might actually have to do a flashpoint or two before I go there.
Cruel nemesis, torment me no further. I surrender. I'm not worthy of finding Orsilio Gan. He was depending on me, and I failed.
You're an officer in the Imperial military. Pull yourself together.
Yes, my lord. I apologize.
I've tried everything. I've even gone back to the medallion to see if my mentor left me any other clue.
If the Imperial Reclamation Service knew how many codes I violated trying to decipher this medallion, they'd have me stripped of my rank.
Don't worry, I won't report you.
Thank you, my lord. I suppose I will just have to let it rest. Perhaps when my mind is fresh, I can evaluate the situation from a new angle. Wait, why didn't I see this before? The medallion came with a chain. It wasn't the original, so I thought it wasn't important. How wrong I was.
I often find when something's difficult, it helps to approach it from another direction.
Once again, my limitations are exposed. If you'll excuse me, I must examine the chain more closely. I'm confident it's the key to finding him.
I believe in you, Talos. And one more to go.
So, are we getting married or what?
I didn't think you were the type to get tied down.
Neither are you. Makes us perfect for each other.
Hurry up and marry me before I change my mind.
Deal. I know you don't want me turning sentimental. I gotta say it. You are beautiful.
Just shut up and kiss me.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, dang, son. Jonico's got moves. I actually wasn't planning on having my Inquisitor marry him, but I guess that's just how it happens. Well, anyways, that is going to be it for this one. A bit of a shorter one, but that is okay. So we have all of our companions finally. I'll probably take Zalik with me to Corellia, but we will just have to see. But in the meantime, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bones out.